Yo guys, long time no see. 223 Frank the Tank here, and it's currently extremely dark on the carrier deck, and we're gonna do a nighttime J-Sound mission. So I got four piggies loaded, and let's go ahead and get rid of the wheel chucks. Wheel chucks,
remove the wheel chucks.
So I've been just, you know, teaching myself some F-18 stuff, using Chuck's Guide and all that. Pretty fun playing. It's enjoyable using that modern technology. I'm on the CSG2 server, the one that we use for practice and whatever you want to do. So we have some SAM sites left over from last night. One of our guys was in a Harrier messing around. So yeah, let's take off from the carrier. Turn this off. Extend our launch bar. So I spent the last 10 minutes inputting JSON waypoints. I'm only doing four at a time, just to see, because this is my first time, so I just want to make sure that we have success, you know? I'm not going to spend 20 minutes doing waypoints and end up hitting nothing. So hopefully it works out. So let's see. So we're going to go ahead and spread our wings. Going into our position lights. And do a little wipeout. Throttle up. Got to turn on my this right here. Okay, we're off into the black. Positive radar. Getting an altitude. A little scary at night. Start turning toward the waypoint. Oh shit, we're burnish. That's not good. Oh shit, we're in burners. Well, we didn't really use up too much fuel, so I guess it's not too bad. Yeah, like I said, it's really hard to figure out what the hell this thing is in, to be honest. Let's get a little flyby. That Hornet enhancement, sound enhancement mod sounding really good right now. We've chilled back on the throttles a little bit to grow out of burners. It'd be nice if it had like the little detent clunk that people are putting to the Tomcat, where you hear a nice audible clunk, so you know that you got put into burners or that you're going past a detent. And then when you pull back, you hear another clunk, like it's unclunking itself. That's really nice, because that's how I find military power really easily. I don't have to look at anything, I just listen to it. In the Hornet, I find myself looking down my engine RPMs constantly to make sure I'm not in burners. And I did not know that 96% throttle acted as burners. I thought it would have to be about 100, but no big deal. So here we are, we're getting closer to our drop point. We got four piggies away. really funny name. At 30,000 feet, those SA2s probably aren't going to be able to, one, even detect us or launch at us. We've got two SA2s as targets, a BTR, a T-80 main bell tank, and a Shulka anti-air, little anti-air tank, like the ones in Battlefield. So we're about a minute from our drop, as you can see on the HUD. 1 minute timer, and hopefully everything works out, and I'll put us into a little orbit and we can watch these things fly in. So we're about 30 nautical miles from our target, from our waypoint, which is going toward the target. So from this speed and altitude, you can see that the JSON has a pretty good range, probably about 20 nautical miles, which is a pretty good standoff range for a bomb. I mean, 20 nautical miles is pretty far. But let me take a look with night vision. I think we should be clear of mountain ranges, to be fair. So when we get within the in range, I'm just going to drop them anyways. I'm pretty sure that those targets are at high enough of a peak that it's not going to dip lower than the target altitudes I've set. That's it, guys. So yeah, I'm probably going to drop at about 20 nautical. I'm going to wait till 20 to drop it. Really make sure I'm nice and in range. I'll be staring here to make sure it's cycling through the waypoints. Okay. Pig away, pigs away, pigs away, pigs away. Four pigs away. I'll slow myself down and go into a nice holding bank over here. Background sounded pretty good. So looks like they're tracking towards the waypoints I've set. We'll just wait around here. Just chill. We could actually even start heading back towards the carrier, so yeah, just full on get rid of this, get my ILS set up, and start heading back towards the carrier. Pilot to start heading back towards the carrier for heading select. See how those bombs are coming along? Looking good. We're gonna watch from this drone. Ooh, from the Mark whatever Predator. So there's our mountaintop. Ooh, it looks like it's going to be tricky. Especially if I didn't consider that some targets might be on the other side of the peak, so oops, that might be a failure on my end. But look, there's the bombs right there flying in. Yeah, that was dumb. I didn't even consider that I could only hit one side of the peak. But let's watch this shit go down right here. Come on, little piggies. Why are you dropping so low? No. Oh, okay. Whoa. That's weird. Kind of just flew up like that. Come on, piggy. Miss. Miss. No. Oh, four of them missed. Oh, this is so sad. Well, with every failure, you will learn something. So that's today's lesson. And on my ILS channel set to the carriers, ILS channel 5. I'm gonna follow those needles in. But first, I have to get lined up on the final recovery course of 107 degrees. So that's what I'm doing right now. Still dumping some fuel.
Bingo. Bingo.
Yeah, bingo fuel. This is not stressful at all. Case one, it's the air boss.
Fuel low.
What matters that we made it back on the boat?
Bingo. Fuel low.
Bingo. Deedle.
Bingo.
There you have it, folks. I don't know what wire I caught because Airboss didn't want to tell me. But what matters is that we're alive and we made it back for another day.
Chief, remove the wheel chocks.
Have a good one. Catch you on the next video.